Do you know? There's a pizza place. They're totally serious, right? There's a pizza place my kids like called Papa John's. I had no idea. Hi, my name is John Papa.
And I'm Brian Clark.
And today we're going to learn 5 things about NLP, natural language processing.
Well, now you just ruined my answer for the first question.
Thing 1, what is NLP?
NLP stands for natural language processing. It's about helping improve the human language interaction with the computer. That's it.
So, talking to your device?
Yep.
Do you often talk to your device?
Many times a day, actually.
Does it answer back?
It does.
Is it your friend?
Yes. We're quite close now.
Really?
Yeah.
I gotta try that. Thing 2, what can you do with it? And why would I use this?
Well, if you think about like Amazon Alexa, Google Home, Siri, you can talk to it, and then the AI will kind of try to understand that language that you're providing to it and break it down. So, or you can even send like messages and it'll break down text messages as well. Not text messages in the form of a mobile device, but like strings.
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 Yes.
Like that one.
All right. You like to break down strings?
Yes.
Break it down.
Yes. So it'll parse out the string to figure out what words, what's the grammar being used, things like that. And there you go.
All right. Thing 3, training. I assume that we're talking about training of the device here, right? How do we train AI to do this for us?
Yeah, so to train the AI, you need to provide it some sample data to learn from. Okay. Just kind of like you're training an animal. The more repetitions that you provide it, the better it'll be at understanding what you're trying to do. I already am sitting, actually. What am I doing? I don't know what that was about.
What was that?
But I was trying to extra sit.
Does your dog do that?
I was sitting really well.
So we train these devices through the AI to recognize words and speech patterns?
Yes. So you can have it recognize things like colors, locations, when people try to speak about a location to understand that better, and so many different options that are available to you.
That's pretty neat.
Yep.
Thing 4. What are some practical examples that you've worked with for natural language processing?
Well, so I use Lewis, which is Microsoft's language understanding service, and I use that in a way so that I can send messages to it from a bot, actually, to turn my light on or off or change the state of it in terms of color, or to try and trigger effects, like blinking the light different colors or party mode.
So you can do all sorts of things then. I imagine like you could speak into a device and then maybe get directions on a map.
Yes.
Or you could turn on Brian's lights at his house.
Right. Other practical examples would be, you know, question and answer, kind of talking and understanding that.
Maybe FAQ while you're traveling?
Yes.
That'd be pretty neat.
Yeah.
We should build that.
We should, actually.
All right. Thing 5, how do people get started with Lewis?
Well, I got started by going to lewis.ai. And there they had a UI that allowed me to learn more about it. I have no background whatsoever in this type of stuff before, and I was able to get started with it very quickly through there.
Yeah, I went to that UI with you, and some of the things that really stood out to me was how easy it is to use, and they teach you things like intents and entities. So what are intents and entities?
Yeah, so intents is about what the message intended, like the person saying it or sending that message intended to do, and Lewis will try to break that down and understand it.
That's the processing part, right? Where it tries to translate into, what did you intend this for?
Yes, and so we can train Lewis by giving it what's called utterances. So what are natural ways for our example, the light, we'd say turn the light off, or in your case, turn dad's office green or something, right? And so those are utterances that we would pass into there, and the intent is Lewis will break that down through its training to understand that the thing that you want to change a state of is dad's office, and you want to change it to the color of green, right? So it can break down that utterance that way.
And then the entities are the things inside of those sentences, right?
Yes, yep. So we can train it so that it can do a certain set of colors only you want to limit it to, or a certain set of devices that you want to control in the house, not the whole house, just dad's office, right? Things like that.
And inside the UI, there's a nice training button. So we type these things in, then we can press train it, and it can learn more about how we're intending it to work.
Yes, and on top of that, you can test it directly in the UI, so you can try new, like maybe you didn't send in an utterance to train it with, and you want to try one that wasn't used before, and see if it actually learns on the fly. You can use the little test UI to send that message in and see how it goes, and how Lewis breaks it down.
So what's the URL you'd ask people to start at to learn more?
Lewis.ai and Microsoft Docs.
Awesome. Thanks for coming on, Brian.
Thanks for having me, John.
I'm John Papa.
I'm Brian Clark.
And we just learned 5 things about natural language processing.
Chest bump.